There's two issues that are related to this that I'd like for you to give us input on, or at least consider. One is the hours of operation. We have had discussions, some of you have been here for Commissioner Evans. Can remember when we had times where we had a different closing requirement from the municipality, which led to some issues of people leaving one establishment, going to another, one establishment closing, but activities taking place out in the parking lot that was more problematic. So the board said we're going to equalize those closing times. So the question that we've had some discussion about, should we separate that out and go back to a longer period of operational hours as opposed to being concerned about what the hours are for any other establishment in a municipality? That's one issue.
Okay.
The second issue is, as it relates, and it's kind of referenced a little bit, is our ordinance related to adult entertainment establishments.
I thought it was one and the same after 12 o'clock.
Well, it could be part of it. but when this came into being, it was 2009, and there was considerable discussion about it. Well, there has been some discussion that maybe this ordinance is too restrictive for the establishments based, again, on our makeup as a community of military and college or university students. Talk among yourselves.
I'll be first to tell you a little bit. In regards to the first thing that you talked about, extending the hours, I think we saw from that yesterday what we got going for us financially, what makes money or that we see gaining ground in our area. So from a money standpoint, if you're not getting the splash or tax dollars during the day, I just think we can make it at night, get it at night, and then as well, I just feel as a business owner, I can understand. I don't go to those places. I don't own the place, but I know McDonald's is open. I know
their menu is a little different.
Yeah, McDonald's is open, Taco Bell, and ultimately it's their risk that they invest in their businesses to even be open. And people probably get on the new level, that's why we got more money. But for the most part, it's that risk, not to mention the establishments that closed, was one of those, the ordinance went into place. So it's not that we won't be forcing nobody to go into place. It's an option. If we want to be business friendly, if we want to have an environment that's welcoming to, say, the college crowd, the military crowd, it's just something to consider.
I don't mind.
I mean, to
throwing my 2 cents worth
to be out of the place.
I honestly feel like that 2 o'clock is plenty. If you ain't found what you're looking for by 2 o'clock, you need to just go home and take your blow-up doll with you. Reality, and that don't go in.
You don't get that choice.
I do know that at big college communities, the establishments necessarily they get started at 6 o'clock in the afternoon, not at 10 o'clock in the evening and then go all night long. I have a concern as much as anything for the safety of the citizens out there that may be moving around, going to work and going to different places at early morning hours, and you've got somebody that's been in a bar from 6 o'clock in the afternoon to 4 o'clock in the morning. Now, that to me becomes as much as anything a safety issue for our community. Now, we say, well, we've got law enforcement, we've got municipal law, we've got county law, and it's up to them to patrol it. When we hear about folks, impaired drivers, that's killing people just about in this state every single day. And from my standpoint, I honestly believe that if you can't get what you're looking for by 2 o'clock in the morning, then that should be the end of it. Business industry, the business people, they have to make a decision about whether or not I can survive selling my product that I'm selling within the hours that I have to sell my product. And if it means they have to, a beer is $2, maybe it needs to be $2.25 because they don't have another 2 hours of operation time, for example, then that's decisions, again, that business people may have to make. Well, I just, from me looking at it, I just don't think going to 4 o'clock in the morning on our alcohol ordinance is just a good place to be.
I think those same individuals are going to go to the mini market and get the alcohol. I'm not looking at it from the alcohol standpoint, I'm looking at it from the social aspect of it. So somewhere from that hangout that's contained and you know where they are. Those same individuals, all the mini markets are open. They can buy alcohol 24/7 at any of the convenience stores. It's still there.
This may surprise some of you, but I agree with Marcus. I kind of feel like, I mean, I've said before, I think the less involved we can be in people's business and in their personal lives, the better off everybody is. I guess I'm kind of in the middle because I agree with the chairman that, you know, we do have a responsibility to the citizens at the same time. But my trouble, what I think is there's something in the middle. And it's, I just don't think it makes sense to go in and tell a bar owner that he has to close the doors at 2 o'clock and clear his parking. I think that probably is more harm to the public than it is by saying we're going to stop alcohol sales at 2 a.m. And if you want to keep your doors open until 4, you know, I know you could argue that, well, then it's last call and you can buy a bucket of But I mean, if you're really talking about public safety, I mean, is it smart to tell a man close the door at 2 o'clock, stop serving at 2 o'clock, and push everybody out in the business road? So, I mean, I'm kind of somewhere in the middle. But generally, I mean, if I'm undecided on something, I kind of tend to lean more towards individual rights and business owner rights. And we shouldn't be involved in telling a man when he's got to open and when he's got to close. And kind of like my position I took on the trash thing, you know, I mean, what you can charge and can't charge, and we need to be regulating that. We're not willing to regulate my outrageous cell phone bill. And so what's the difference? I mean,
I just have a different point of view about the safety issue. You're right. They can go by the mini market and they can get a six pack of beer and they can go to one of our wonderful parks and they can just guzzle it on until 4 o'clock or 6 o'clock in the morning if they want. That's going to happen.
Until a popo shows up.
Yeah, until a popo shows up. a lot of them are going to take that and then go on off.
Is there any evidence out there? Have we done any?
Well, I think it would probably be a good idea along those lines. So let's get some input from the sheriff's office and see what kind of, what they're looking at. I mean, they're making traffic stops all the time. The sheriff's department, the state patrol, the city police, to look and see where are the hours or where the majority of their impaired drivers are coming from. You know, if it's at that 2 o'clock rim. You know, if I was a policeman and I was on duty and I was looking to get me somebody, I'm waiting for 2 o'clock for the doors to close and everybody's got to leave, because I guarantee I'm going to get one of them. You know? the issue is that there's some valid information on both sides. And you won't be able to think that you would be able to use that the ugly R word and say that you can regulate a community
to be more responsible.
That's not going to happen. I think, though, that what you've got to be careful about and be cautious about is, again, consider the public safety issue of it, number one. And then number two, look at it and see, is it too restrictive from a business owner to say that you have last call at 2 o'clock?
We're probably at 1:30 because you have to be out at 2.
Well, I mean, whatever. I mean, let's just use as an example that if you wanted to move toward leaving the establishments, allowing the establishments to stay open a little bit, it's up to the police departments and the sheriff's departments then that after 2 o'clock, you walk into an establishment and if there's alcohol being served or alcohol being consumed, that's a problem. Now, if they're all in there eating hamburgers and hot dogs and shooting pool and trying to work off that whiz that they got all day long, then that's a different situation that law enforcement has to look at. So maybe we need to talk to the sheriff to see if we can get some data that will kind of help us with that decision about where we want to go. I mean, it's a great thing to bring it up and look and see if it is something that's too restrictive to our entertainment that we have in the community. Is it too restrictive for them? And at the same time, are we restricting other opportunities for entertainment establishments, which would be beneficial to the citizens that likes to use those establishments?
Well, I think it's important to remember that there's a different group of people there now. I mean, we were talking about, it is surprising that a lot of folks don't go out. College kids don't even go out until 9, 10, 11 o'clock. I mean, I was always wanted to be home by 11 or 12.
Yes.
I couldn't hang, so to speak. But and from the feedback that I got from the main sketch from one of the bar owners was, you know, well, if they're not coming out until 10 or 11 o'clock, you know, a lot of times they'll say, well, we'll just go have a party at somebody's house, or we'll go elsewhere. We won't frequent the establishments because, you know, we're not going to get there until 12, and then we've got 2 hours, and then we've got, you know, we're going to be forced out of there. So it wasn't that they wanted to continue selling alcohol from 2 to 4. It was that, you know, just we'll stop selling at 2, and then if people want to stay and go forward, then stay.
Because I know some of those children that you're referring to, their college age and all of that, they get pretty well where they want to get before they go out at 9:30 or 10 o'clock. So, because it's cheaper for them to drink at home, find somebody to take them and drop them off so they don't have to drive. And then he knows.
On the weekend, you'll see them walking, college students walking at 9, 10, 11. It's not early. They wait.
But they start drinking whenever they want.
Yeah.
And so, because it's cheaper to drink at home than it is to drink at the bar. Mm-hmm. So they get drinks at the bar. But that's not their primary get lit. It's before they
I would challenge each of y'all to go, and nobody's going to do it, but to go sit at Bay Tree at like your Zachary News is or whatever, looking across the street or into 2 o'clock.
you'd be shocked at the volume of people that are flooding those sidewalks. I mean, you can't even turn right on red for pedestrian traffic at 2 between 2 and 3.
And it's like I said, I know I'm not in that car, but I realize the time and the individuals that I have to, they don't go out to a lot later. You know, that's just the new thing, and if nothing else for the social component. Because like I said, the availability of alcohol is continuously there around the clock for the new markets.
Well, what if, couldn't you eliminate that too? Couldn't you say no alcohol sales of any kind between 2 and 5? 2 o'clock in the morning, 5 o'clock in the morning?
Yeah.
That's
what we're saying.
Yeah, what happens?
Well, he's expanding it all the way out to the middle markets and everybody.
Man, I'm just thinking to solve your problem.
Well, it is my problem. I don't believe it. I guess us, our government, telling me they can't, in a sense.
Well, to follow
up. I understand the safety side of it. I'm not forcing anybody to go, and I don't want to force somebody not to.
So, are y'all promoting that we become like Colorado?
What's the point? That's what you're
talking about.
Well, I'm saying, you're saying we shouldn't be restricted.
Well, too.
So, what are you going, are you not going to restrict anything? Is it going to be everything? What are the business?
It's a legal operation.
To explain what Commissioner Evans was referring to, the way that the whole thing started at this point was, it did start with the difference in the hour. You have the city closing at 2 o'clock and the county not closing until 3 o'clock. And so what was happening is people would leave at 2 whenever the city had last call. Law enforcement was complaining to the county because there was a big haul of everybody instead of going home, they were going to the county and drinking for another hour. And then those same officers were having to mutual aid each other and come in and out of the city and the county to get the clubs and the community closed down for the second time. And so then we made the change to say, you know, our hours were the same. Then we saw Deja Vu out on Highway 84. West opened up, and they weren't selling alcohol because they couldn't get alcohol license. But they had bands and dance music and all that. So then they were allowed to stay open until 4, I think
it
was.
They had an alcohol license, but they couldn't stay open right past 2. And so they said, oh, we'll give our license back, and we'll just let everybody brown bag.
And so people were drinking in the parking lot, and we had to put the brown bag ordinance in because we were having to pay the fire marshals and code enforcement overtime because they were having to go clean the club out. Law enforcement overtime was through the roof. And then you had people like, I spoke to the owner of several establishments, Cousins being one of them, that had a full food menu as well. And he said, it's not fair for me to have to close down if you're going to let these after-hour people sell food and be open for people to drink out of the parking lot, because I sell food too. And, you know, I could be open for another hour and make money off of just food. And now they don't have the expense of an alcohol license, but everybody's drinking in their parking lot. They're drunk in their club. They're listening to the music, and they're paying $15 for 6 hot wings because people are drunk and they need food before they can go home. Yeah. So all of that mess got sorted out into what we're doing now.
But I'm with the chairman on this. We have a responsibility to the citizens of this county, the city, for their safety. And this garbage going on, that's not safe. So no way to say.
You need to cut it out on the answer. We're dropping you in. We care about.
In reality, you do have to look at all points of view. If you're going to be a community, as Mr. Pritchard said, if you're going to embrace, and I'm not trying to identify any particular segment, but if you're going to embrace the young airman at Moody Air Force Base that's looking for entertainment, looking for something to do, they're single people, if you're looking to embrace Ball State University, and those students, as we know right now, Ringerton exists for the most part primarily because of BSU. And those students, they have a place to go or go to that place. If you want to expand on that and look at Valdosta and as doing that, then certainly your ordinances is going to be, the ordinance is going to be the path that you're going to have to go through to change that. I have no objection to taking a look at, to agreeing to take a look at that ordinance, draft a couple of different options in it, and then if it's something that we decide, you can decide to support it or decide to reject it, when you get ready to approve that change in that ordinance. My opinion about it is that it, I can't move off the fact that certainly there's a lot of folks that might want to stay out after 4 o'clock drinking. I just can't see the need for it. I just can't do it. I mean, at 2 o'clock, you ought to be on your way home, and the majority of them that's on the way home at 2 o'clock shouldn't even be going home in their vehicle. There should be somebody else taking them home. They're past being able to drive a vehicle at 2 o'clock.
Where are you coming up with the 2 o'clock?
2 o'clock where we currently have.
I mean, but who says 2 o'clock? Like, why not midnight? Why not 10? Why not? I mean,
why do you say 45 miles an hour? Why do you say 70 miles an hour?
That's a good point. but I'm saying my issue is not necessarily the hour. It's shutting down and saying you have to stop serving and you have to clear your parking lot at 2 o'clock. That's where my name.
Well, couldn't we make any difference?
Yeah, if you want to back it up and say no alcohol sales after midnight, but you can stay open until 2. I mean, I didn't entertain that. I'm just saying, shut them down at 2 o'clock and then have somebody push them into their vehicles and push them out on the main road, and then I'm sure that actually happened that way, but within 15 minutes. That's what, I think that's more harmful for public good than it is.
Well, again, I think that's part of the ordinance of what you need to look at. Now, I do agree with the issues that came about when you got a community such as Lowndes County with a large municipality in it. You've got one set of hours closing here and one set of hours closing here. That certainly is going to put a stress on law enforcement, and you're going to have people racing across town to get into unincorporated areas of where there might be a bar out over there that might be opened up at 4 o'clock. If you wanted to look at it from the standpoint as you're saying, say, okay, there's going to be a last call, you might say, we're going to, you know, can't serve alcohol after this hour, but you can stay open 24/7 if you want to. You know, from that standpoint, but it's food only at that point.
I think a lot of places also, when I work out there, when you go, you want to come in. It's not like you want to just keep going different other places, especially at that time of night. And I'm just saying that if a person stays out for 4 or 3, it doesn't mean they're drinking. It can be they're just talking, they're socializing in a good environment.
That's what I told my daddy.
I'm just being honest. It ain't that many people that can drink that long. You got people that can't handle the rules. Yeah. But then you got some people that really want a place to chill out. The social aspect of it.
One of the other problems we have with Jacob, just besides all the drinking and things in the parking lot, is we have a lot of noise complaints with them too. All the neighbors were constantly calling. And that's a lot of times they had to get shut down.
And they exceeded the occupancy.
Right.
Yeah. Frequently. I mean, Commissioner Marshall is right. I mean, if you want to go out there to socialize, and you used your children as an analogy, and this don't go in the paper, but I'll use my children as an analogy. I've got one that when they go out, he's a designated driver because he doesn't drink. But still, he enjoys going out with the group and having fun. But he can have fun without getting intoxicated.
He's enjoying seeing everybody else.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I have one of those and two that are opposite.
Yeah. But the point is that you're right. There are some people that's looking for a place for entertainment. They go in there to listen to the music, to whatever it is, and socialize. I get all that. But the issue and the problem that we really have and we're trying to address it is through our alcohol license. And the alcohol license and ordinance is there because we're dealing with alcohol. And so that's what we need to address in that. If there's an issue with our entertainment or our establishments allowing for someone to go and socialize, then there may be a way to mold that in there. But it is also an issue that you have to deal with, as we have experienced, is the issue with these establishments trying to circumvent the ordinance by just simply saying, all right, you can have it all.
10 pictures at 2 o'clock.
Yeah.
But what if we made it no sale or consumption on a commercial establishment between 2 and 5?
That's something to consider.
But that's sales tax for the minute markets. I'm just putting it out there.
You go out at 5 or
6. I mean, all I'm saying is, I just think that's very restrictive.
Didn't they used to put padlocks on cooler doors in the minute markets?
Listen, I've got a liquor cabinet in my home, and I make sure that whatever's there, if I choose I want it, I don't wait till 4 o'clock in the morning to go get it. I've already got it there.
Well, my question and comment is, refresh me, when we changed the ordinance last time, where were we before the ordinance changed?
Before the ordinance changed, the city of Alaska closed and cleared at 2 o'clock. We closed and cleared at 3 o'clock. That hour, according to local law enforcement, and what we were paying the fire marshal and code enforcement overtime on, was the hour of horror.
And I appreciate and respect that, but I'm not concerned about financial. I'm saying, has our fatality rate gone down by backing that up enough?
That would be a question for law enforcement.
Yeah. I think that goes back to the fact that we probably need to get some input from local law enforcement. I wouldn't have any objection to asking the sheriff and asking the PD to see if they've got data to help us with this issue.
Would it be beneficial if we got Moody's input to command out there on this type of
stuff? I don't think we need to go there.
Looking after their people?
Because I think you'd be asking that individual to be put in a bad situation. Certainly, it's a double-edged sword for him. They definitely would be looking at, they want to make sure that their airmen, that their need for entertainment is fulfilled, but he also don't want a bunch of drunken airmen coming back to his base, and he's got to deal with that, on base or off base. So that's a real double-edged sword for him, so I don't think we need to
do that.
When the change was made before, though, statistically, law enforcement spoke in favor of the change, as well as 911, because of their volume of response and the call. There was a tremendous amount of violence at Deja Vu for that period of time that we went there. There was several stabbings in the parking lot and shooting.
Excuse me, just a minute. Right along those lines, that's where I really get my cockles up, is when we have one bad apple that ruins it for everybody else. That's where there's a real problem as well. Now, if we went in there and changed our ordinance simply because one establishment was creating the problem, our focus should have been on not changing the ordinance that's going to affect everybody, do what we need to do to shut that crowd down.
That's
kind of where I'm at.
They were operating.
I hear you, and I know that, but that's when I have an issue, though, is when we change things because you've got one bad apple in the bunch. Then,
work on that. Alcohol license is.
And I know it's hard.
I'm not proud of it, but that's cherished by them. Make an example out of one person who sells out to 2 a.m. and revoke their alcohol license and shut them down for violating the ordinance and work it around. So the whole fear of, they still want to sell, and who's going to really police it, and all that.
They didn't have an alcohol license. This was once they gave their alcohol license up, and they were just staying open as a non-alcoholic dance club. Yeah, that was just to your question on the hour.
And that may be why they saw, we don't have an alcohol license, and what are they going
to
do?
That was alternative lifestyle, though, too.
And I think it's also, this should play a beyond factor, but I think it's important to recognize that the issue of Roanoke is a lot higher than it is.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, they all dropped out. Just put that out there. Do you want to, the next one is animal services. Do you want to just talk about dog entertainment, or do you want to go all the way to that and